Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome back. Mora Morsi here with another episode going over a vintage Harry Potter game. In this episode, we're going to go over the Harry Potter Quidditch game. It's a really cool board game. It's pretty interactive. It's got a lot of moving pieces and a really nice launcher for you to get that quaffle in through the hoops. So we're going to go over it. I'm going to show you what it looks like. Let's get started.
Okay, this is the Harry Potter Quidditch board game made by University Games. We've got 7 players on each side, and you can play with 2 people controlling each 7, or you can play with up to 14 people, and each one of them has 1 player. We would roll the dice, and we will move the players. You can choose which player you move if it's just you and somebody else playing. And then once you move the player and it lands on a token or next to one of these tokens, then depending on what that token has on it will depend on what happens next. There are 2 bludgers. These are the Seekers. We've got Gryffindor and Slytherin are the 2 teams playing against each other. Keepers, 2 beaters on each team, 3 chasers for Gryffindor, 3 chasers for Slytherin. If you roll the dice and one of your chasers lands on a token, and if it's a quaffle, you take this token off of the board and you put the quaffle sticker on your chaser like that. Now this chaser has the opportunity, instead of moving on their next turn, they can decide to shoot the actual quaffle and try to make it into a hoop. In order to get the bludger onto the field, the first 2 times that a 1 is rolled, with the player who rolled that 1, they place the bludger on the board. Players may place bludgers on any space next to one of their beaters. This is the launcher for the quaffle, and in order for the beater to use it, it has to be placed a little bit off of the board, and then they can physically launch it into one of the hoops. Some of the tokens have other symbols on them. This one right here is a Nimbus 2000, which represents speed. So that means that if you choose this token, the next turn, you get to roll twice. This is the Hogwarts crest. If you choose this, nothing happens. You just continue on with the game. You don't get any penalties. You don't get to shoot the quaffle or anything. This is a slow potion. If you turn over this token, you're unable to move on the next turn. If you choose this, it's a penalty token. If that's the case, then you are out of the game for 1 full turn, and when you come back, you have to start near your hoops at the very beginning. The last token that you can flip over is the Snitch, which of course awards the team 150 points and wins the game. The team with the most points wins the game.
All right, everybody, that'll do it for today's episode. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed.